Hello class 7th, how are you all? So from today we are going to begin chapter number 1. Did you remember that last time we studied the chapter motion? Yes, actually motion chapter is also in 6th class. That's why in the beginning I taught you motion chapter. Now from today we are going to begin your course, book course. So from today we will start. Okay, the name of chapter 1 is nutrition in plants. So in this chapter we will study about the nutrients, what kind of food different kind of plants eat, because all the plants are living organism. Yes, so they eat different food, and how do they eat? We will also study how do they eat, and we will study about the nutrition, different mode of nutrition in different kind of plants. So this is our aim. So without wasting time, let's start. Okay kids, so today's first topic is nutrients. Yes, you might have studied about nutrients in your lower classes when you were in 5th, 6th. So what is the meaning of nutrient? Nutrients are actually those substances which provide us energy, for growth and development of body. Yes, they provide energy for growth and development of body and to function properly. Yes, and repair the body. Yes, this is the main work of nutrient. So substances in your food that your body needs to function properly, to grow, repair itself and supply you with energy. Those substances are known as nutrients. Yes, or in very simple way, if I tell you a simple definition, so what are nutrients? Components of food which provide energy and maintain the function of body are called nutrients. Or in another words, I can say substances which provide energy for growth and development of body are called nutrients. Okay, there are 6 basic nutrients as you can see on the screen: carbohydrate, fat, mineral, protein, vitamin, water. And we also need dietary fiber. Dietary fiber is not a nutrient, but we need it because it helps us to remove the waste from our body. Okay, understood? Now let's move on to the next point. Okay, so you know that we eat different kind of nutrients we eat for the growth of body, and the process of eating these nutrients. When you eat something, it goes through your food pipe in your stomach, then it digests in small intestine, large intestine. So your body utilizes it. What is your body doing? Your body is utilizing this process in taking food and utilization by body for energy is known as nutrition. So what is nutrition? The process by which the body takes in and uses food. Yes, the process by which the body takes in and uses food. The process by which the body takes in and uses food. The process by which the body takes in and uses food is called nutrition. Yes, nutrition is one of the most important factor in keeping a healthy and long living body. Yes, nutrition is one of the most important factor in keeping healthy and long living body. So what is nutrition? The way of eating, the mode of taking nutrients, the mode of taking nutrients, those nutrients will be absorbed by your body, utilized by your body. When your body will utilize, then those nutrients will provide you energy. Yes, those nutrients will provide you energy. So this process in which your body take food, in which your body take food in and then use it and utilize it. Your body take food in, then use it. Use the food means utilize the food. So if you are eating healthy food, then it will keep you healthy and make your body long living. Yes, that's why nutrition is the important factor. So understood? So what is nutrition? The process by which the body take in and uses food. Or in another word, I can say nutrition is the mode of taking food and utilize by the body. Nutrition is the mode of taking food and utilization by the body. It's called nutrition. Understood? Now let's move on to the next point. Okay, kids. So, next topic is modes of nutrition. Yes, modes of nutrition. So you already know what is the meaning of nutrition, the process by which the body take in and uses food is called nutrition. There are different modes of nutrition. Yes, there are many type of plants, many type of animal, and in all plants, animal, there are different mode of nutrition occur. In this chapter, we will study about the mode of nutrition in plants only. Yes, we will study the mode of nutrition of plants. Okay. So there are two type of mode of nutrition: autotrophic nutrition, heterotrophic nutrition. Okay. So in autotrophic nutrition, two kind of mode of nutrition occur: photoautotrophic nutrition and chemoautotrophic nutrition. And heterotrophic nutrition can be divided into four parts: holozoic nutrition, parasitic nutrition, symbiotic nutrition, and saprophytic nutrition. Holozoic nutrition, parasitic nutrition, or you can say symbiotic nutrition, saprophytic nutrition. saprophytic nutrition, or you can say saprotrophic nutrition. So there are two type of nutrition. There are two type of nutrition: autotrophic, heterotrophic. Autotrophic nutrition, heterotrophic nutrition. Autotrophic nutrition can be divided into two parts: photoautotrophic nutrition and chemiautotrophic nutrition. Photoautotrophic nutrition and chemiautotrophic nutrition. Heterotrophic nutrition can be divided into four parts. Heterotrophic nutrition can be divided into four parts: holozoic nutrition, parasitic nutrition, symbiotic nutrition, saprophytic nutrition. Holozoic nutrition, parasitic nutrition, symbiotic nutrition, saprophytic nutrition. Saprophytic nutrition is also known as saprotrophic nutrition. Okay, so today we will study only about autotrophic nutrition. Yes, today we will study only about autotrophic nutrition. And in heterotrophic nutrition, you can see four type: heterotrophic nutrition, holozoic nutrition, parasitic nutrition, symbiotic nutrition, saprophytic nutrition. In all, first, what is the first? What is the first name? The first is holozoic nutrition. Holozoic nutrition occur in herbivores, carnivores and omnivores. Yes, you already know about them. So we will not study holozoic because you already know what are herbivores, what are carnivores, what are omnivores. Okay, if you don't know, then take the book of third or fourth class and study. Okay, now let's move on to the next point. Okay kids, now at first let's begin autotrophic nutrition. So what is the meaning of autotrophic? Actually, this word is derived, this word has come from a Latin word. This word has come from a Latin word which is auto plus trophos. Auto plus trophos. Autotrophic word is made from two words: auto plus trophos. Auto means self. Auto means self. Trophos means nourishment. Trophos means nourishment. Yes, it means autotrophic means self-nourishment. Means it making food and eating self. Making food and eating self. Yes. Now the question is, who make food itself? Who make their own food? Yes, we know that green plants make their own food. Green plants make their own food. So what is autotrophic nutrition? Organisms which prepare their own food are called autotrophs, and such type of nutrition is called autotrophic nutrition. Yes, organisms which prepare their own food are called autotrophs, and such type of nutrition is called autotrophic nutrition. So green plants have autotrophic nutrition. Green plants have autotrophic nutrition. It means green plants prepare their own food. Green plants are known as autotrophs. Yes, those organisms in which autotrophic nutrition process occur, in which autotrophic nutrition process happen, they are known as autotrophs. Yes, they are known as autotrophs. Yes. So auto means self, trophos means nourishment, means doing self nourishment. So what is autotrophic nutrition? Autotrophic nutrition, organisms which prepare their own food are called autotrophs, and such type of nutrition is called autotrophic nutrition. So all the green plants, yes, all the green plants prepare their own food. So all the green plants are autotroph, and their mode of nutrition is autotrophic nutrition. Understood? Now let's move on to the next point. Okay kids, before we understand something more to get knowledge, something more about autotrophic nutrition. I want to teach you one more topic, that is nothing else but sale. Yes, sales. Then we will study again autotrophic nutrition. Okay. Let's start. So, introduction to sales. Sorry. So, what are sales? What are sales? Cells are the basic units of organism. Yes, cells are the basic units of organism. Yes. Our body is made up of cells. Yes, our body is made up of cells. Yes. Do you know to make house we use bricks? Yes, one bricks upon another brick, then one more brick, then there is one more brick. So different bricks make a house. In the same way, different cells make the body of animal. Yes, all the living organism in the world, all the living organism, insect, animals, human being, plants, yes, the body is made of cells. Okay, so cells are actually very smaller in size. Yes, you cannot observe them. Cells can only be observed under microscope. Yes, we can see the cell under microscope. Yes, how does cell look like? Cells look like just beehive. Yes, have you seen the shape of beehive? Yes, cells just look like beehive. Yes, actually there are three basic type of cell: animal cell, plant cell, bacterial cell. Yes, animal cell, plant cell and bacterial cell. As you can see the picture of animal cell, plant cell and bacterial cell on the screen. Actually, there are actually mainly two type of cell, eukaryotic and prokaryotic, which are not given in your book. But till lower classes, you just need to know that only about animal cell, plant cell and bacterial cell. So let me give you a brief introduction about animal cell and plant cell, so you can actually understand today's topic. Okay, so in the beginning as we discussed that we eat nutrients and they are absorbed by the body. We eat nutrients, different kind of nutrients, carbohydrate, fat, vitamins, protein, and they are absorbed by the body. Actually, body is absorbing means our cells are absorbing. Yes, that is the meaning. Cells, our body is made up of millions, trillions of cells, and these cells absorb the nutrients. Yes, that is the main point. Okay, these cells absorb the nutrients. So the body of living organism are made up of cells, and cells are the basic structural unit of organism, or you can say cells are building block of life. Yes, building block of organism. Okay, as you can see two picture of cell, plant cell and animal cell. Can you see the picture, animal cell and plant cell? These are not actual picture, these are not real picture. Okay, these are not real picture, plant cell, animal cell. But just for your information, I have shown such kind of picture, so you can understand the basic meaning of plant cell and animal cell. Okay, look the structure of animal cell. Can you see the word written cell membrane? Cell membrane, cell membrane. Can you see? Yes, in violet color, in violet color. Can you see cell membrane? Yes. So cell membrane is the outer cover. Yes, cell membrane is the outer protective cover. It allows the material to move in and move out. It allows oxygen and carbon dioxide. Yes. It allow oxygen to move in and carbon dioxide to move out. Okay. Mitochondria. Can you see the word mitochondria? MITOCHONDRIA, mitochondria. Yes. Mitochondria is known as powerhouse. Powerhouse of animal cell. Okay. Cytoplasm. Can you see the word cytoplasm? CYTOPLSM, cytoplasm. Cytoplasm in sky color, blue sky color. Yes. Cytoplasm is actually a jelly-like liquid. Yes. In which mitochondria, nucleus, ribosome, they all are present. Can you see the word nucleus? Yes. Nucleus. Nucleus is actually a main controller. It is spherical in shape. In animal cell, nucleus is present almost at the center. It is central located. Nucleus is central located. Now look the structure of plant cell. In plant cell, nucleus is also present. Yes. Don't forget, in plant cell, nucleus is present. And can you see the green outer covering? This green outer covering is cell membrane. Yes. Plant cell also have cell membrane. Plant cells also have cell membrane. But cell membrane is covered by cell wall. But in plant cell, cell membrane is covered by cell wall. In plant cell, cell membrane is covered by cell wall. But in animal cell, cell membrane is not covered by cell wall. It means cell wall is not present in animal cell. Cell wall is not present in animal cell. But cell wall is present in plant cell. Can you see the word chloroplast? CHLOROPLST, chloroplast. Yes, in chloroplast, you can see in green color, green spherical structure of chloroplast, green spherical structure. In chloroplast, chlorophyll is present. Yes, in chloroplast, chlorophyll is present. Okay. You already know, I think, about chlorophyll. If you don't know, we will discuss about it later. Okay. So I hope you understood. It was the basic information about cells. It's a basic structure. You need the body of living organisms made up of cells. Okay? Understood? Now let's move on the again autotrophic nutrition. So, as you know that kids, autotrophic nutrition means organism prepare their own food. Green plants are autotrophs. Now the question is, how do they prepare? Green plants prepare their own food by photosynthesis. Yes. Green plants prepare their own food by photosynthesis. So what is photosynthesis? Plants make their own food by photosynthesis. We know. You already know about this one. Plants make their own food by photosynthesis. This process is a chemical reaction that uses light energy. Yes. Actually, plants use light energy, and this is actually photosynthesis is actually a chemical reaction, a chemical process. Yes, photosynthesis is a chemical reaction, or you can say it is a chemical process. Plants use sunlight. Yes. What is the meaning of photosynthesis? The word photosynthesis comes from Greek language. Yes. Photosynthesis word has come from a Greek word, photo plus synthesis. Photo means light. What is the meaning of photo? P-H-O-T-O. Photo means light. And synthesis means putting together. So the simple meaning of photosynthesis is putting together with light. Putting together with light. We put something with light. We put something with light. So photo means light, synthesis means putting together. Photo means light, synthesis means putting together. So photosynthesis just means putting together with light. So what do green plants put together to make their food? Now the question is, what do green plants put together to make their food? Yes, they put together carbon dioxide, water, and many more. So photosynthesis, point number one, photosynthesis is a chemical process. Okay, photosynthesis word come from two Greek word, photo and synthesis. Photo means light, synthesis means putting together. So what is photosynthesis? Photosynthesis meaning putting together with light. This is the meaning of photosynthesis. Now we will see the definition and the process of photosynthesis. Let's move on to the next point. What is photosynthesis? Let's see the definition. The process of making food. The process of making food by plants using carbohydrate, water, mineral, in the presence of sunlight is called photosynthesis. The process of making food by plants using water, carbon dioxide, minerals in the presence of sunlight is called photosynthesis. So as you can see on the screen, can you see the picture of plant? Yes. So plant take water. Step number one, plant takes water and mineral from root. Step number two, plant takes sunlight or sunlight energy from the sun. Plants take sunlight energy. Or you can say leaves take sunlight energy from the sun. So step number one, plants take water and mineral from the root with the help of root. You know? Next, plant takes sunlight energy from the sun. Step number three. Plants take carbon dioxide with the help of leaves, which is present in the surrounding. Okay. Now, there are many holes present in leaves. There are many small holes present in leaves. Yes. With the help of these small holes, plant take carbon dioxide. You know, we take oxygen with the help of our nose, and there are two holes in our nostril. So in the same way, plants in the leaves have many holes. With the help of these holes, plant take carbon dioxide. So plant use carbon dioxide, water and mineral, and with the help of sunlight, they convert carbon dioxide and water into carbohydrate. They convert carbon dioxide and water in the presence of sunlight into carbohydrate. carbohydrate give energy, or you can say they make glucose. They make glucose. You can see on the screen, sunlight plus carbon dioxide plus water. Arrow I have shown during photosynthesis. They convert carbon dioxide and water into glucose and oxygen. Glucose means carbohydrate. Glucose means carbohydrate. So, and they release oxygen. During photosynthesis process, they release oxygen. During photosynthesis process, they release oxygen and we take that oxygen. Okay? Understood? Now let's move on to the next point. So kids, now the question is, where does photosynthesis take place? Where does photosynthesis take place? Photosynthesis takes place in leaf. Yes, leaf. Leaf is also known as food factory of plant. Photosynthesis takes place in leaf. Leaf is also known as food factory of plant. At first, plant take water and mineral with the help of root. There are many small pipes are present, very thin pipes, means small veins. There are many small thin pipe veins are present in whole plants. So when plant take water and mineral with the help of root, the root carries water and mineral to the leaf. Yes, the root carries water and mineral to the leaf. Yes. So, all the process of photosynthesis occur on the surface of leaf. The photosynthesis process occur on the surface of leaves. Yes. Understood? So, plant take carbon dioxide plus water in the presence of sunlight and they release oxygen and make which food? They make carbohydrate. Yes, carbohydrate means glucose, glucose food they make, which provide them energy. Yes. And as I told you that how does plant take carbon dioxide? There are many small holes are present in leaf. With the help of these holes, plant take carbon dioxide. Understood? Now let's move on to the next point. Okay. Now I have a question for you again. Does photosynthesis occur in green plants only? Does photosynthesis occur in green plants only? No. My dear kids, no. There are many flowers, many plants which are actually different in color. Yes. But they all have chlorophyll. They all have chlorophyll. Yes. Because chlorophyll is needed in photosynthesis process. Yes. Without chlorophyll, plants cannot make their food. Yes, without chlorophyll, plants cannot make their food. So, in the presence of chlorophyll and in the presence of sunlight, plant take water and mineral and carbon dioxide and convert into carbohydrate and oxygen. So photosynthesis process not only occur in green plants, it occur in many plants like desert plant. If I talk about desert plant, in desert plant actually the plants do not have leaves. Their leaves are actually turned into spines. Yes, their leaves are actually turned into spines. Yes. So, but their stem is green. Their stem is green. So, green plants, so photosynthesis occur in stem also. Yes, photosynthesis occur in stem also. ओके. सो वी कैन से दैट फोटोसिंथेसिस नॉट ओनली अकर इन ग्रीन प्लांट्स बट ऑल्सो अकर इन डिफरेंट कलरफुल प्लांट्स. यस, बिकॉज इन कलरफुल प्लांट्स ऑल्सो हैव क्लोरोफिल. इन कलरफुल प्लांट्स ऑल्सो हैव क्लोरोफिल. वॉट इज द वर्क ऑफ क्लोरोफिल? क्लोरोफिल गिव्स ग्रीन कलर टू लीव्स. क्लोरोफिल गिव्स ग्रीन कलर टू लीव्स. बट देर आर मैनी प्लांट्स हुज फ्लावर आर नॉट ग्रीन. वाई? बिकॉज दे ऑल्सो हैव डिफरेंट कलरफुल पिगमेंट. क्लोरोफिल इज अ पिगमेंट बट इन कलरफुल प्लांट्स हैव डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ पिगमेंट मोर देन क्लोरोफिल. दैट्स वाई देयर कलर इज डिफरेंट. ओके, अंडरस्टूड? नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट. एज आई हैव रिटन ए क्वेश्चन ऑन द स्क्रीन, वॉट इज स्टोमेटा? यस, स्टोमेटा, STOMATA, स्टोमेटा. Have you ever heard about stomata? Okay. Few moment ago, actually, I told you stomata, about stomata, but you didn't pay attention. What is stomata? As I told that there are small holes present in leaves which help to exchange gas, which help to take carbon dioxide in and oxygen out. Small holes present in the surface of leaves. With the help of these holes, plant takes in carbon dioxide and take out oxygen. Yes, these small holes are known as stomata. Yes, these very tiny pores. So stomata are pores. Stomata are pore means stomata are hole. Stomata are pore in a plant, in a plant skin, through which water and gases are exchanged. Through which water and gases are exchanged, the plant and the atmosphere. Yes, you can see the shape of stomata. Stomata is actually plural word, singular is stoma, stoma. So you can see the picture of stoma, one stoma. You can see the picture of one stoma. It is green in color. So stomata helps in exchanging the gas. Yes, stomata helps in exchanging the gas. Or in simple word, I can say stomata, actually stomata are noses. Stoma is nose. Stoma is nose of plant. Yes, we take oxygen in and carbon dioxide out with the help of nose. We breathe in and breathe out with the help of our nose. In the same way, plant breathe in and breathe out with the help of stoma. With the help of stoma. So stoma is plant's nose. Understood? Now let's move on to the next point. Okay kids, now let's know something more about stomata. Stomata is plural word and stoma is singular word. Stomata is plural word, stoma is singular word. Okay, stoma means pores in a leaf, you know, pores. So they are found on the undersurface. Stomata are found on the undersurface. Stomata are found on the undersurface. Yes. Now the question is, who protect the stoma? Who protect the stoma? Who protect these holes? Who protect spores? Who protect pores? Each pore is surrounded by a pair of guard cell. Yes. Each pore, each hole, each pore is surrounded by, protected by a pair of guard cell. Yes. Two cell protect one stoma. Two cell protect one stoma. Okay. Each pair of guard cell protect the stoma. Yes. So what is the work of guard cell? First work, it protect the stoma, it protect the spores, it protect the pores, it protect the pores. First work, guard cell protect the pores. Second work, guard cell can change the shape of stoma, yes, to open or close the stoma. Guard cell can change the shape to open or close the stoma. You can see the in picture, when plants take in carbon dioxide, then guard cell open the stoma. So you can see the picture of open stoma, when guard cell open stoma, stoma take carbon dioxide. Yes. So when guard cell turgid, swollen, turgid means swollen, that time stoma, through stoma carbon dioxide goes in and oxygen come out. But when guard cell is not turgid, means it is flaccid, shrunken, it is flaccid, shrunken, okay, means when it is closed, when guard cell is closed, when guard cell is shrunken, or I can say when guard cell is flaccid, when guard cell is closed. Closed means shrunken or flaccid. Closed means shrunken or flaccid. When guard cell is closed, stoma do not exchange carbon dioxide and oxygen. Stoma do not take carbon dioxide and do not take out oxygen. But when guard cell is turgid, means when guard cell is open, when guard cell is open, plants, stoma take carbon dioxide in and oxygen out. Understood? Now let's move on the next point. Okay kids, to understand the chlorophyll, we need to know one more term, that is chloroplast. Did you remember in the beginning I showed you two cell, animal cell and plant cell. And in plant cell chloroplast is present. In animal cell chloroplast is not present. In plant cell chloroplast is present. In animal cell chloroplast is not present. Yes. Now let's talk about chlorophyll. Yes. Chlorophyll is present in chloroplast. Can you see the picture of chloroplast? Yes. This is the picture of chloroplast in green color. You can see. So, chloroplast found only in plant cell. Yes. Chloroplast contain a green pigment called chlorophyll. Yes. Chlorophyll is a green pigment. Due to chlorophyll, plants leaves has green color. But there are many leaves which are not in green color. They are in yellow color, red color. Why? Because they also have chlorophyll, but they also have different color of pigment. The different pigment more than chlorophyll. That's why their color is different. Their leaves color is different. So, what is the work of chlorophyll? Chlorophyll is essential for photosynthesis process. Chlorophyll absorb the sunlight. Yes, this is the process. Chlorophyll absorb the sunlight. So, plants take water and carbon dioxide and mineral. Yes, plants take water and mineral, and with the help of stomata, plants take carbon dioxide and plant take means leaves. Leaves take sunlight with the help of chlorophyll. So, point number one, root take water and mineral. Point number two, stomata take carbon dioxide. Point number three, chlorophyll absorbs sunlight energy. Understood? So chlorophyll is essential for photosynthesis, the process by which plants make food. Understood? Now let's move on to the next point. So kids, as I told you that sunlight is absorbed by chlorophyll, but do you know sun is the ultimate source of energy? Yes, sun is the ultimate source of energy. Yes, how? Because the sun provide energy for photosynthesis. Yes, sun provide energy for photosynthesis. So sun is the ultimate source of energy. It helps plant in photosynthesis. Yes, and because of photosynthesis plants grow. And plants provide us food, we know, because of photosynthesis process. If photosynthesis process will not occur, then plants cannot make food. Plants cannot produce oxygen. Yes. Okay. So photosynthesis, without sunlight energy, photosynthesis is not possible. Yes. Without sunlight energy, photosynthesis is not possible. At night, sunlight is not available. It means at night, photosynthesis does not occur. At night, plants do not make food. But during the day, plants make food in the presence of sunlight. Okay, understood? So today I want to ask you one question before leaving today's class. At night we get the light of moon. Can plants make food with the help of moonlight? This is the question for you. You will find the answer. Understood? Now let's move on to the last point. Okay kids, it's time to ask question from you. Question number one, define following nutrients and nutrition. So what are nutrients? Substances which provide energy for growth and development of body are called nutrients. Okay. Or you can say that components of food which provide us energy and maintain the function of body. And nutrition. What is nutrition? The process, the mode of nutrition. Nutrition is the mode of taking food and utilizing by the body. What is nutrition? Nutrition is the mode of taking food and utilization by the body. Okay. Next is what is photosynthesis? Explain. Photosynthesis is a process in which plants take carbon dioxide, water and mineral in the presence of sunlight to make carbohydrate. To make carbohydrate means glucose is called photosynthesis. Understood? Question number three. Sun is the ultimate source of energy because it helps plant in photosynthesis, and without photosynthesis plants cannot make their own food. Now what is stomata? Stomata are small pores surrounded by guard cell which helps in exchanging the gas. Okay, understood? Today's lesson is finished. Now we will meet in next lesson. Today we studied autotrophic nutrition. Tomorrow we will study about heterotrophic nutrition. Till then, goodbye.